I am Anil Kumar, sharing with you few questions to practice what we have learned in evaluating exponents. So let's begin with the very first question, which is evaluate 2 square plus 2 to the power of 3. 5 options are given to you. So how should you do it? You can always pause your video and then look into my suggestions after you're done. So we have 2 square plus 2 cube. 2 square means 2 times 2, which is 4. And 2 cube means 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8, right? So let's be very clear. 2 square means 2 times 2. And 2 cube means 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. So we could write this as 4 plus 8, which is 12. So the correct option is B, right? So let's move on. Now the next one is 1 cube times 2 square times 3 to the power of 0. We need to evaluate. So it is 1 cube times 2 square times 3 to the power of 0. Anything to the power of 1 is always 1. 2 square is 2 times 2, which is 4. We will multiply these. Anything to the power of 0 is how much? It is not 0. It is 1, right? It is always 1. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. So when you multiply these three terms, you have to multiply. This really means multiplication. So the answer is B, 4. There could have been an option 0 also, right? Okay. The next one here is, we'll understand few rules of exponents with this exercise. You need to evaluate 3 to the power of 5 divided by 3 to the power of 3. So we have 3 to the power of 5 divided means like this, right? You might have seen like this. That really means we'll subtract the powers. That means 3 to the power of 5 minus 3, which is 3 square. 3 square means 3 times 3, right? Which means 9. So the correct option is C, which is 9. Now we have a power rule for exponents. We need to evaluate 2 square cube. So 2 square cube really means 2 to the power of, you have to multiply 2 and 3, right? You have to times 2 and 3. So we get 2 to the power of 6. Now what is 2 to the power of 6? That is what you have to evaluate. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. So 2 times 2 is 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. So the answer is E, 64, right? Now we have decimal numbers to some power. Evaluate 0.3 to the power of 2. Now when I say 0.3 square, it really means 0.3 times 0.3, right? So whenever you multiply, you have to have same number of decimal places. So there is one place and one, so we need two decimal places. So first multiply 3 and 3. What you get is 9. And then think about decimals. We need two decimal places, so the decimal comes here. So the answer is D. You would also think like this. 0.3 means 3 over 10, right? 3 over 10. So we're talking about 3 over 10 times 3 over 10. That means 9 over 100, right? So when you divide that, you get 0.09. So at times, you can think about decimals as fractions. It is helpful to think like this also. Here we have radicals. We're trying to find square root now. Evaluate 36 to the power of half plus 2 to the power of 0. So let me rewrite this. 36 to the power of half plus 2 to the power of 0. To the power of half means square root. So it means 36 square root plus 2 to the power of 0. Square root of 36 is 6. 6 times 6 is 36. And anything to the power of 0 is how much? Not 0. It is 1. So 6 plus 1 is 7. So let's move on. And the next one here is 16 to the power of 0.25. Now that is again a decimal. So it could be written as 16 to the power of 0.25. Now what is 0.25? 0.25 could be thought of as quarter, right? 25 over 100, which is 1/4. So I'll write 16 to the power of 0.25 as 16 to the power of 1/4, right? And 4th root of 16 is, think like this, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16, and the 4th root. So we get the answer 2. So option B is the right option. Correct? Okay. Now we have to evaluate 4 over 9 to the power of minus half. Now that is, let me rewrite this. It is 4 over 9 to the power of negative 1 over 2. Negative makes it reciprocal. So we should write this as 9 over 4 to the power of half. Correct? That really means square root of 9 over square root of 4. Right? And that means 3 over 2. Right? So 3 over 2, which is option C, is the right option. Few more to go. Right. So now these are the tricky ones, and they are kind of difficult. So this is, we are getting to a very difficult set of questions now. If 3x minus 2y equals to 2, evaluate 27 to the power of x divided by 9 to the power of y. I should take this as part 2. Okay, this will take as part 2. Some of you who have not learned this kind of thing may skip this part, right? So let's continue with those who are interested in. Okay, so what we have here is, if 3x minus 2y equals to 2, evaluate 27 to the power of x divided by 9 to the power of y. So let me rewrite. We have 27 to the power of x divided by 9 to the power of y. 27 can be written as 3 cube, right? So it becomes 3 cube x divided by 9 is 3 square, 3 square y. Do you get it? Now, since the base is same, we could write this as 3 to the power of 3x minus 2y. We are given 3x minus 2y equals to 2. So I could write this as 3 to the power of 2, which is equal to 9. So the answer is 9. Correct? So that was difficult. Let's move on to the next question, which is even more difficult. It says, evaluate 2 to the power of x divided by 2 to the power of y in everything to the power of x plus y, where x equals to 3 and y equals to 2. Okay, so we are given 2 to the power of x divided by 2 to the power of y, everything to the power of x plus y. We'll do this later. Okay, now we should do inside first. So inside we have 2 to the power of x minus y. Since we are dividing x minus y, everything to the power of x plus y, right? Now that gives you, we have to multiply these two since power rule. So 2 to the power of x minus y times x plus y. Difference of squares, we should get this as equal to 2 to the power of x squared minus y squared. Do you get it? Now, x is 3, y is 2. So if x is 3, y is 2, let's calculate what is x squared minus y squared. X squared minus y squared means 3 square minus 2 square, right? Y is 2. That is 9 minus 4, which is 5. So I can replace this by 5, right? So we have 2 to the power of 5, which is 32. So the answer is D. I think now we are moving on to the last one. I hope you have learned from these examples and you have found them interesting. The last question here is to evaluate 2 to the power of x divided by 2 to the power of y to the power x plus y. However, now x and y values are equal to 3. So I think I can leave this for you. We have 2 to the power of x over 2 to the power of y, right? Everything to the power of x plus y. Inside term is 2 to the power of x minus y. Outside we have power of x plus y. That could be written as 2 to the power of x squared minus y squared. Since x and y is equals to 3, x squared minus y squared will be kind of 3 squared minus 3 squared, which is 0, right? Since x and y are equal, it is 0. So what we get here is 2 to the power of 0, and anything to the power of 0 is 1. So the option is B. I hope you understand and appreciate now how we can evaluate exponents. And with this range of examples, you should be in a position to solve most of the questions. Feel free to post suggestions, subscribe to my videos, and if you like, that would be great. Thank you, and all the best.